It's Operation Crimson Stone Week here at Corvus Belly, and we have some epic boxes to give away. Drop your comments using the hashtag Operation Crimson Stone on YouTube, Twitter, or Facebook for your chance to win a copy of this new Infinity Code 1 Battle Pack. Good luck, and keep connected.
We're jumping now on the other faction, which is Ariadna, okay, which is the low-tech faction, the settlers that were totally stranded in the universe and then find out after generations of populating planet Dawn, okay, so the leitmotif of this faction has always been low-tech, almost like 20th century weaponry and techniques and guerrilla warfare, okay. But now they have jumped into space. They are trying to put their feet on the human sphere in a certain way and having an army that can operate in sci-fi environments, okay? Which is something new for Ariadne in a certain way. So we have here units that belong to a sectoral army that is called Cosmoflot, that you don't have to be familiar with if you are a newcomer, but obviously the veterans are talking about Cosmoflot, obviously, yeah, everybody knows about Cosmoflot now, because it was a new thing last year. Okay, so let's talk about the light infantry, which are the rockets, okay, light infantry for Cosmoflot, for Ariadna. This is the male and female concept design for the rockets. As you can see, it has kind of, in a certain way, to me, has a certain vibe for like a James Bond movie in a certain way, because you can see obvious elements from classic 20th century uniforms of soldiers, okay? But they have no camo pattern, for example, which is very common in Ariadna, but these guys are going to be in space stations. There's no meaning for having a camo pattern. Paint them in low saturated colors and you will have kind of something that reminds you of a 60s James Bond flick in a certain way. Moving on, the first Highlander SAS, okay, the SAS for Ariadna, classic Infinity figure, okay, that has been through lots of different figures, but finally we have here the first 3D model, that is a female, okay, we decided to make a female this time. Certain classic traits for this unit in Infinity, okay, wearing a mask, okay, and apart from that, has an anti-gas mask on the elbow, okay, which is something that has always been present in all everything, all the SAS figures, okay. This time carrying the boarding shotgun and an axe, because why not, okay, an axe right there, okay. This is a classic camo skirmisher, okay, for Ariadna, and specifically for the Caledonian Highlander Force, and now for Cosmoflot. Don't worry, these words confuse you, okay, you have to focus on that this is a camouflage unit that can be infiltrated on the battlefield for your Ariadna army. First regiment of paracommandos, classic Infinity troop, but this time with a totally different design. If you are a veteran and you remember the old classic Merovingian paracommandos, they have nothing to do with this new version, which has been updated and has a lot of common elements with the Cosmosoldat also, and is more designed in order to be believable as a operating unit in a space station. Okay, this was once again a French unit from the Ariadna army that has been totally redesigned. And finally we have the 3D miniature arriving here in a combat position, which is the ones I like the most. Let's take a little 3D render here. I love when the posing, when you have figures that are totally in a realistic position in action. I like those more than the I'm here with a sword in the battlefield pose. I really like the ones that are really in their own movie, okay, shooting, running. This kind of action pose really brings everything to me. It has a lot of meaning. As you can see in the color scheme, the orange breathing tubes really get a lot of attention, and that is a cool point when painting your army, really. Paracommandos, Merovingian, okay, now for Cosmoflot, here they are. Volkolak Shock Troopers, okay, this is a kind of a werewolf unit. If you are not to Infinity, it will totally shock you, but yes, there are werewolves and many different kinds in Ariadna, okay, because it's part of being in an alien planet for generations, okay, and having encounters with the local fauna. So they end up having werewolves among their men in Ariadna. And this is kind of a wolver, okay, which is half a werewolf, not a fully Duke Warrior. Don't worry, if you get into Infinity, you will read about this and learn all the different kinds of wolves that are in Ariadna, which is something, the kind of the flavor of Ariadna, something delicious to enjoy. You can go full army with werewolves if you want, okay? There's armies that allow that to happen. This is a Volkolak, which is like a heavy infantry for Ariadna, for Cosmoflot in space. And because all those four elements cannot exist within each other, it ended up being a werewolf. I mean, it's totally impossible to happen, okay? But you have there a werewolf with a heavy machine gun, with a heavy armor in space. Crazy concept, okay? I can imagine realistic sci-fi units like in the Nomad Army, like totally spilling their drink after looking at something like this. This is your hammer in the Ariadna Army, in this Operation Crimson Storm box. Okay, so use it wisely and don't allow them to get crazy, okay? Use the HNG and blast everyone away. Zenith 7 Detachment, this is the High Elite Sniper for Ariadna in Cosmoflot, okay? Has a camo poncho, but it's like a pixel camouflage. We understand that poncho is an intelligent cloth that can adapt to the camouflage pattern that better suits the sniper in the environment, okay? You have to think about that. It's a female with a gas mask, okay? It's something that we really like it. Usually having lovely, attractive female snipers is a classic trait of Ariadna since the beginning of this game, okay? And this is the Zenith 7 Detachment. Place her in a sniper nest, obviously, having a lot of line of fire, and you will deliver the best result with the unit, okay? Camo unit in space for Ariadna. I would love to see a male version of this, really, in the future. Moving on, we have to now to talk about one of the most crazy ideas for this box, which is the pre-order exclusive figure, which is Wolfgang Amadeus Wolf, the mercenary wolver and probably opera composer also, apart from everything like that. He is in a very aggressive position, okay? He's a wolver, so he's half a werewolf, okay, from Ariadna, obviously, but has been around for the human sphere, so has seen a lot of different factions of the human sphere, and it's a figure that can be playable both in Ariadna and Nomads, in Corregidor and Cosmoflot, obviously. So it's a figure that can combine with your Ariadna army or your Nomad army. This is absolutely legal in Code 1 and also in M4 tournaments, okay? So this is a crazy concept. We, in a certain way, in the color scheme, mixed a little bit of Nomad color scheme with a little blue, that is something distinctive from the Ariadna Cosmoflot units, okay? And we go totally wild, so there's a little blood stains on the clothes over there. I really like the translation into 3D. They really put out all the potential of having those claws in the fist, okay? And very aggressive position. This works very well for close photos, okay, with the macro lens on the face of this character. It's obviously the kind of figure that has one particular angle where all the photos are amazing, okay? But it's a very good miniature, okay? It could have been the exclusive miniature from the bundle if you wanted to say that. Really works in 360 and very aggressive, okay? Has a lot of violence in it. So we really like this miniature. But also there's this extra box that totally combines with the Operation Crimson Stone box, which is the Dire Foes Mission Pack Xanadu Rush. Xanadu has some feelings, has vibes from a 70s musical, this one. Okay, so we're talking about here two already well-known and very popular Infinity characters. In fact, we're talking about here heroes from the Defiance, okay, the dungeon crawler that Infinity, that Corvus Belli was launching back in 2019 as a crowdfunding campaign, okay. We have here Cadding First Strike, okay, the Ariadna hero, okay, playable also in Cosmoflot, which is another Wulver. So we have already three Wulvers here, okay, with this setting. And it's a wild beast carrying two machetes, and we can see here as the new miniature, okay, the infinitive playable figure, okay, this is how he looks like. Okay, and if you like the better the Defiance one, hey, good luck if you were a backer, okay? And if you like even better the alternative pose for the Defiance one, congratulations, you can play that with that in Infinity now, okay? So, Ariadna unit for Cosmoflot, for Ariadna, okay? Cutting First Strike now playable and now arriving to you as a regular release from Corvus Belli. And what is for the Nomads? For the Nomads we have two miniatures, okay, because we have Jazz and Billy, okay, that is, this is kind of like a Zoe and Peewill from Bakunin, was the same for Corregidor, okay, Jazz and Billy, elite hacker with a remote that is going, is its own independent unit also. So, two figures for Nomads, hey, you're winning right now at something, I don't know what. This is a character known from Defiance that has now been release as a playable was already playable, but now is the regular release from Corvus Belli for in order to make it playable. Take a look at both miniatures, okay? And take a look at the level of detail that the Jazz sculpture has next to the Billy sculpture, okay? I can tell you something. Obviously, the sculpture put some extra work on the human female Jazz figure right there. She has a detail level of detail in 3D properly, that not from a 28 or 32 millimeter figure. That looks like a 75 millimeter figure. If you look at the lines of Billy, her remote, it's a much more well-made sculpting for a miniature that is going to finally be this big, because that level of detail is enough for printing and having that miniature. But if you look at the clothing, at the stomach, at the lines of the clothes, I'll take a look at how well portrayed those were translated into 3D. Okay, that's something subtle. That requires some sculpture and some talent over there. So, lovely figures and lovely profile for the Nomads with Jazz and Billy right there. Now, every Dire Foes mission pack brings an extra VIP or HBT. This one is the Tech Lab, okay, a laboratory technician that is perfectly executed to be dancing in distress or not. Maybe she's a very empowered and efficient woman. We don't know. It depends on the narrative that you put in your missions, okay? That is the extra miniatures of we end up having a Dire Foes mission pack with four figures in it. And all of them are independent, okay, because Billy is not just an attachment next to Jazz, it's an independent figure, playable also. So, when you put together Jazz, Billy, and Wolfgang Amadeus Wolf, you have 10 figures with the Nomads, which is a whole combat group, which is so cool, okay? Finally, the last figure of the whole bunch is the exclusive blister of the Dragon Lady, which can be used as an HBT for any kind of faction. Yuching, Yuching. But it's a lovely figure, okay, with a kind of a Chinese outfit, with a lantern. It's a lovely for painters. It's a figure that is obviously lovely for people who enjoy painting and make lighting effects right there, okay? We have a constant design. This is like an alternative version of a HBT figure that we released long ago from Corvus Belli, but this time people were so interested and so into it that we decided to make an exclusive powerful blister for the whole operation Crimson Stone. This has been the concept design 3D video of the whole Operation Crimson Stone theme week. We hope you enjoy these kind of videos, just showing a little bit of the process and sharing with you some secrets of the way Corvus Belli does things. We hope you enjoy this week. Please drop your comments below using the hashtag, whatever hashtag Crimson Stone is having this week, I can't remember. Probably it's one of the corners of the screen, don't worry. Drop us your comments, let us know what you think about this, and if you like what you're seeing, hey, click and buy the box. It's just that easy, okay? So thank you so much for your attention. Bye.